By Andy Rito, the registrar of political parties, about the initiative they have taken to ensure that the joining of parties and resignation from parties is done through integration with the e-citizen. That's a very progressive initiative, and I want to urge Treasury to ensure that without any delay, there is the money that the Office of the Registrar of Political Parties need, so that we can now see in reality which parties, you know, have what, which members. Right now it's very complicated process for people to leave one party and join another party. And so people are actually finding themselves, one, either in parties they didn't join, or actually, you know, they are locked in parties they would want to leave. So we would want to see, you know, that being progressed. I would agree that we have the most expensive elections in Africa, probably in the world. But also Kenyans have to ask themselves why we don't trust each other. Because the reason that we have got, you know, the bloated budget, or in fact per capita, per vote expense on our elections is among the highest in the world. Because we don't trust each other. You find countries like in the US, whereby, you know, even people who, the returning officers, are part-time workers, and they go and they conduct elections, and then they declare the result, and everybody trusts that. And also, you know, the elections are conducted at state level. We don't want to see that kind of devolved elections management, whereby if it's Muranga County, even if it's a presidential election, you finish that business in Muranga. You just send your results. So this thing of sending all the results to Nairobi and creating the tension in the country, we would want counties to be enabled. We have county elections board at county level, so that we're able to consolidate all the results, and then we can send the results here, which is just for tabulation purposes. So this issue of trying to transmit all the results to Nairobi is also making our elections very expensive, first of all, and secondly, you know, creating tension in the country when we look at that. So let's finish this business at county level, and let's also, as Kenyans, have trust on each other. Let's not believe that the next guy wants to steal elections. If we do that, the cost of elections is going to be low. We should have, actually, I would have said monthly before, but now because we have got only 52 weeks before the next general election, we need to have this on a weekly basis. We need to have meeting one all the way to meeting 52 of all the 73, 74 registered political parties, so that we can be able to, you know, to scrutinize the progress we made, you know, as we get to 2022. You know, this is not an event, it's a process. So we need to have a continuous stakeholder engagement, preferably on a weekly basis, so that we can be able to engage and see how we can be able to improve. So that we don't get into next year, then some people, as they are used to do, they start saying that kimeibiwa. So we need to have that engagement on a continuous basis. And if we do that, by the way, given the extra money that he's asking for, we will be his, you know, advocates to talk to Treasury to get them more money. Once we are convinced that they are on the right track, do we have the equipment that we need? All the, you know, KIMS kits, are they working? What kind of failures can we expect, you know, on election day? So we need to engage on this thing. So let Chebukati not, you know, close doors and, you know, lock himself up there. You guys in the media were here last week, exactly Tuesday last week, when we were at Kabati for the funeral of Joel Kibe's mother. And you could see national leaders who were there. The Honorable Raila Odinga, the Honorable Musalia Mudavadi, the Honorable Wetangula, and the Honorable Kalonzo Musyoka. And only these leaders from out there were given a chance to address the people. My good friend, the local MP for Kadera, Alice Wahome, local MP was not given a chance. And something, you know, rang a bell in my mind, that if you're not careful as Mount Kenya region, we are going to be spectators of Mashemeji Derby between Gor Mahia and AFC Leopards. We are going to be like spectators of the Olympics, to see other people in the game and we are not in the game. It is not possible and it's not practical, it's not acceptable at all. And we should not be called tribalists when we say we need a party to advance the agenda of our region. That's a reality. There's this road here that goes to Makeji, which myself and the Honorable Kimani Ichung'wah, when we were in the budget committee before we were, you know, unfairly bumped out, we put money there because I know where Makeji is and I know where Kandera is. I really cannot, you know exactly about that road in Siaya, but I can contribute to this part, then another part, and together we form a mosaic of parties that are going to build a nation. There is no nation that can be stable without pillars. And the pillars that make the nation are political parties. So I think it's unfair because we've already agreed for the first time in 30 years that you're not going to have someone on top of the ticket from this region. Now we agree to that and still you want to deny us a chance of having a party. It's grossly unfair. It's unacceptable. I don't care whether I'm shut out of government, this one or the next one. But I will start with that one because, you know, I'm speaking for millions of people who want a party that is going to advance about our roads, about jobs for our youth, about our businesses, about our milk, about our tea, yeah, about our coffee, you know, about our rice in Kirinyaga. These are issues that need articulation from a particular vehicle that really understands what is, you know, the underlying issues of that particular region. So let no one call us tribals for doing that. It is our inalienable right, and we're not going to banduki on this particular one. So tuzoyane mapema. Na nima budget ito yake tureno, nemo ya area shigono mono dhino wa Africa, ona hakuwe deode. Na kiri ya mono kesi ukagira, ito yano sitoku ke na garama igoro, neko hagu wetekania. So do, alo wa Kenya meteketi, uzi yoge muna kene muzi, hedisi yote. Kogo kona leo ogonta kole Amerika adola maru maru ga magire idura no talitani officer maba gutiga bela omuda nya hwaine magathie ola matire hago kogo no nyere kuga ola gutuka idura no sina goro a Kenya na omamenye ohoro wa kwihokana ohoro wa kindu itago trust tondu nigura to ma ni tondu mulo dere sire kidiro ni kraiwo ni do ogolu tu.